Videos to allow you to correct your homework for section 3.1.3. An article in the local paper states that 30% of the students at this school earned a place on the Silver Honor Roll. If there are 920 students at Oak Grove, how many are on the Silver Honor Roll? And they want you to use a percent ruler. So remember, the idea with a percent ruler, and I don't know where I have that drawn, I guess here, is that we're going to take a line segment and divide it into 10 parts, each part representing 10%. And 100% in this case is the same as 920 students, because that's all the students. So we know that then half, 50%, would be half of 920 or 460. The other thing we know is, and this is why we break this into sets of 10%, is that taking 10% of something is basically the same as dividing by 10. In other words, 100% divided by 10 gives you 10%. So you can take that 920 and also divide it by 10. Well, dividing by 10 just means basically moving the decimal one place to the left. So 10% ends up being 92. If 10% is 92, then 20% is 92 times 2, 184, and 30% is 92 times 3, 276. In other words, if we know that 92 students are 10% of the student body, we can triple that to get 30% of the student body. So that would be a good way to show your work. Another way you can do it, if they had not suggested you use the percent ruler, is to say, what is 30% of 920? We could change 30% to a decimal. We know of means to multiply. And you could have taken then 0.30 times 920. That would give you the same answer. Here they want you to write each portion as a percent and use the 100% block to help you visualize. So 3/10 and 6/100, remember a tenth is basically a column or a row. So 3/10 would be three columns. And then 6/100, each hundredth is a small little square. So that would be one way to show 3/10 and 6/100. Basically, if you count them up, 36/100. So 36/100 is the same as 36%. Then for B, they want you to do 8/100. So you would basically be showing 8 squares that are shaded, because again, each square represents 1/100. So you would have this, and 8/100 is the same as 8%. It's a little trickier for D, but C is still pretty straightforward. For C, we're doing 17/100. So this is 10. Plus another 7. 17/100 is the same as 17%. And as I said, D is a little bit tougher, which is why we have two of these 100% charts, because 11/10 is more than 100%. So this would be 10/10, which would be 100%. And then another one, another column, makes it 11/10. So 11/10 is the same as 110%. And again, if you think of this like a fraction, 11/10, you can see why it's going to be over 100%, because the numerator is greater than the denominator. Here, this gas tank can hold 60 liters of gas. They want you to copy this percent ruler and figure out how many liters are in this tank in these situations. So first of all, again, a percent ruler means we take a line segment, divide it into 10 parts. Each part represents 10%. So this is 10%, total of 20%, 30, 40, 50, and so on. Then we also need to put how many, in this case, liters of gas are represented by 100%. Well, it says the gas tank can hold 60 liters of gas. So that's representing 100%. So if it's going to be 50% full, it's basically going to be half of that. Well, 50% full would be half of 60 liters or 30 liters. 7/10 full, well, each of these is a tenth. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is 7/10. The question is, though, how many liters is that? Well, if 100% is 60 liters, that means each set of 10% is 6 liters. So this is 6, another 6 would make 12, 18, 24. We already said 50% was 30. Whoops. That did not come out nicely. 30, and then this would be 36, and this would be 42. So 42 liters. Again, that's because each section is representing 6 liters, and we need 7 sections. And then 2-fifths full, well, 2-fifths can be converted very easily into tenths. So if we use our giant 1, 5 times 2 is 10, 2 times 2 is 4. Now, I apologize because that's a terrible looking 10. This is the challenge of writing with a mouse. And the idea is that if I multiply top and bottom by a giant 1 of 2 over 2, that's how I'm getting 4 tenths. Well, that means 4 tenths on here would be 1, 2, 3, 4, right there. 1 section, 2 sections, 3 sections, 4 sections. Again, each section is 6. So 6, 12, 18, 24. So 24 liters. Which of these could add together easily? The key concept you want here is obviously fractions that have a common denominator already are going to be easier to add. So you could talk about any fractions with the same denominator would add together easily. You could also specifically say some, like 5/7 and 1/7, both have a denominator of 7. That's going to be easy to add. Let's see, 2/3 and 4/3 would be easy to add because they both have a denominator of 3, and so on. Some of these also, like 2 over 2 is the same as 1, so that'd be easy to add to anything as well. 3.49, Alex earns this much per day by walking dogs. If he walks dogs for 12 days, how much money will he make? So you need to show, as it said, how you got the answer. So you're taking 775 and you're multiplying by 12. Now remember, when you multiply a decimal times a decimal or a decimal times a whole number, either way, you're going to first of all think of it as though it's just whole numbers. You're going to ignore the decimal to begin with. So how would I multiply this if it was just 775 times 12? Well, I'd take 2 times 5 is 10, put down the 0, carry the 1. 2 times 7 is 14, plus 1 is 15. Put down the 5, carry the 1. 2 times 7 is 14, plus 1 is 15. Then remember, you need a 0 for a place marker. So now 1 times 5 is 5, 1 times 7 is 7, 1 times 7 is 7. So I'm going to do my best to line these up so they add fairly easily. 0, 5 plus 5 is 10, put down a 0, carry the 1. 5 plus 7 is 12, plus 1 is 13, put down the 3, carry the 1. 1 plus 1 plus 7 is 9. So once we've done our multiplying, now we're going to think about our decimal placement. So we have what we call 2 decimal places in this number, meaning 2 numbers or digits behind the decimal point. We have no decimal places in this number because if we don't see a decimal point, we know it's behind the number. So 2 plus 0 means we need 2 decimal places in our answer. To get 2 decimal places in our answer, we're going to come from the back, go in 2 places, and put a decimal point. So we'd get $93. Again, make sure you're showing your long multiplication and that you're pretty good at that. For 3.50, you can use the resource page. You could also use a hundreds chart. Shade in these and then write them in the stated form. So here they want us to shade 0.07, which would be 7 of these little squares, and write it as a percent. Well, that'd be 7%. Here they want you to shade 0.7. Remember, a tenth is a full row or a full column. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 tenths. Write that as a fraction, they're saying. Well, that's 0.7 as a fraction or 0.7. 0.7 would be considered simplified because the numerator and denominator don't have anything they can divide by other than 1, where here we could divide them both by 10. Here they want us to shade 28%. So again, you're going to shade in basically 2 columns of 10 plus another 8 squares. And they want that written as a fraction. Well, that would be 28 out of 100. Again, we typically want you to try to simplify if you can. What will both 28 and 100 divide by other than 1? Well, they would both divide by 4. So 28 divided by 4 is 7. 100 divided by 4 is 25. This is considered the simplified form. And then here they want you to shade 31.5%. Well, 31.5% is a little tricky, as you might imagine. So we're going to go 30% is here, 1 is here, and then we have to try to do a half. And a half is kind of just like a diagonal here. So that is tricky. Now, how do we write that as a decimal? Well, we know 31.5% would be the same as 31.5 out of 100. But we cannot have a decimal within our fraction. So what we do is we multiply top and bottom by 10, because multiplying by 10 means moving the decimal point one place to the right, and therefore we will not have a decimal in our fraction anymore. So we're going to get 315 for the top, but 100 times 10 is 1,000. So we're going to get 315 thousandths. Again, I apologize for it being a little bit messy. How do we write 315 thousandths in terms of place value? Well, we write it like this, 315, 5 has to end in the thousandths place. So that would be the decimal. Given these numbers, which one is larger? Use a words or pictures. So if you're going to do picture, you would show 18% would be 18 of these squares. And 7/10, which is what we see here, would be 7 columns. And we can see that 7/10 is then greater than 18%. Another way we could explain it is we could say we know 7/10 is the same as 70%. 70% is going to be greater than 18%. Or we could have changed 18% to a decimal and compared it that way. Either way, that's always going to be the answer. Here they want to know what this would look like on a 100% block, and they're writing as a decimal. This is very similar to part D here. So what would 78.5% look like on a 100 block? Well, it would have 78.5 squares being shaded. So 78 full squares would be shaded and another half a square. And then just like we talked about before, that 78.5 out of 100. But we can't have a decimal within our fraction, so we need to multiply by 10, top and bottom, to clear out our decimal. Now we're going to get 785 for the numerator, no more decimal, and 1,000 for the denominator. Oops, and that's really messy, I apologize. So 785 thousandths would be the same as 785 thousandths are written as a decimal this way, because remember, that's a 5 landing in the thousands place. So I apologize. Writing with a mouse is a bit messy. What's the sum of these numbers? Well, 2 over 2 is the same as 1. 3 over 3 is the same as 1. So 1 plus 1 equals 2. You could also show it in fractions because they said to do it in multiple ways. You could show, you know, what does 2 over 2 look like? Well, it would basically be cutting this in half and then shading both parts. What does 3 over 3 look like? It would be cutting this in thirds and shading all three parts. Either way, we can see we get 1 plus 1 equaling 2. And again, there's other ways you could probably do it as well. Owen loves to eat hamburgers. He goes to the grocery store. He's going to buy ground beef and buns. He buys the package of hamburger buns for $1.29, the package of ground beef for $5.82. He only has a $10 bill and wonders if he can buy some ketchup and mustard too. Ketchup costs $1.89, mustard is $2.69. He does not have to pay sales tax on food. Does he have enough money to buy both? If he does, how much will he be left over? If not, what can he buy? So what I'd want to see is that you're adding these two decimal numbers. Remember, when you do that, you line up your decimal point. I'd want to see the work for that. And what you find is if he buys all the items, so the 582 plus the 129 plus the 189 plus the 269, it's too much. So he can either buy the ketchup, in which case his total is going to be $9, and I want to see how you got that, or he could buy the mustard, in which case his total is going to be $9.80. So again, make sure you have this, but also showing me some of your work of adding the decimals. Good practice on that.